This is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. Active Directory has been included in Windows Server operating systems since Windows 2000. It's the foundation for many, many businesses. It allows firms to authenticate and authorize all users and computers in a Windows domain. Group Policy provides centralized management and configuration of operating systems, applications, and user settings in an Active Directory environment. It allows administrators to set many security policies, settings, enforce certain actions, preferences. In other words, it allows firms to set standards in an organization. It also allows attackers to identify patterns in a network, as well as use the features of group policy to gain more rights. I often joke that attackers know how to better manage and maintain our networks than we do ourselves. Recently, I spoke with Darren Mar-Alaya, Vice President at Semperis, who I've known for many years as the guru of group policy. Initially, his focus was ensuring that IT professionals used and understood the power of Active Directory and group policy. But over time, he's realized, just like attackers have, that group policy allows you to silently gain more rights into a network and better attack an Active Directory network. In a recent Microsoft security document, they showcase that attackers don't necessarily immediately launch attacks. Rather, they gain initial access, gain credential theft, start to do lateral movement, persist in a network, and in particular, as you see right over there, they do GPO changes. They want to make sure they stay in the network, they hide in the network, and make changes so that they have more access and more rights in the system. Recently, there was a public attack on Twitter that did the same kind of techniques. They specifically targeted administrators, took over those roles, and then made sure they had control over certain tasks, and took over those duties and functions. Darren talked about a number of parsing tools that allowed networks to determine what policies in Active Directory were active and what policies are deployed. Tools like PowerSploit are well known in the attacker community, along with Bloodhound and Mimikatz. They allow the attacker to better understand your network as well as review the relationships of users and assets. We often name our organizational units with very descriptive names that identify what the group does and has rights to. The attacker can wiggle in, identify these organizational units, and start to evaluate who has rights, who has asset rights, and start to look at more things in the network. Bloodhound in particular gives attacker key information to better target and damage your firm. The tool uses graph theory to identify relationships inside the network. With the tool, you can identify the shortest attack paths and identify weak points in your environment. It allows you to see those places that you need extra attention, as well as have a quantitative way to evaluate possible mitigations or changes and compare your security posture between two points in time. Microsoft even talked about this in Baza Loader, that once the attackers gain credentials for domain administrator accounts or other highly privileged accounts, they often stage a ransomware payload on a domain controller using PSExec or group policy. In several attacks, they deployed ransomware in a variant known as Conti. Darren talked a couple of times about how ransomware attacks use various techniques, such as inserting the ransomware into the AD login script, affecting anyone who logged into that AD server. They also observed that the sysvol share on an Active Directory domain controller was infected and used to propagate throughout the environment. Attacking the sysvol share typically requires elevated privileges and indicates a very serious AD compromise. One of the key ways you can better protect your network is to audit and review who has the ability to edit and link to group policy objects. Too often in organizations, we don't segregate and protect our administrative assets. We don't flag and audit when group policy changes are made. If you have not already done so, I urge you to set up DS Objects and File System Auditing and make sure you have this set up on your domain controller. In those audit policies, you want to click on DS Access and set up that logging. You want to make sure that you're alerted when someone's elevated to a domain administrator. That's a very specific action. You need to be alerted when that happens. You also need to be alerted when AppLocker protection is changed. That's not a normal process. That normally goes through a change management process. You need to make sure that you have alerts in place so that when those two events in particular occur, that you're immediately notified. Darren and I also talked about the impact of ransomware on how firms set up protection and backups. Too often, especially with domain controllers, we consider that another domain controller in the environment is the proper backup for a domain controller. There's not an offline backup made. We consider domain controllers to be expendable and recoverable. Yet the infamous ransomware attack Maersk Network, they had no viable recovery of their Active Directory domain structure other than an offline domain controller in a remote location. They literally had to physically bring a solitary clean domain controller back into the network to recover the domain. So think about that. Think about when and not if you will get hit with some sort of ransomware or some other attack that goes after your credentials. Do you have the necessary tools and techniques to first determine when changes were made inside your Active Directory infrastructure, and two, recover your domain controller or other domain information without reintroducing the infection, or can you recover to alternative infrastructure? Do you have the answers to those questions? If you don't, it's time to step back and say, I need a recovery plan. I need to know that should my Active Directory totally burn to the ground, I can rebuild it. I can recover it. You don't want to be like Maersk and have to spend weeks recovering that domain structure. So remember, when it comes to your Active Directory infrastructure, make sure attackers are not using it better than you are. Make sure there's logging. Make sure you know who has access to add organizational units, make adjustments to group policy, and get immediate notifications when changes are made. Until next time, this is Susan Bradley for CSO Online. See you online at the YouTube channel at IDG Tech Talk. Until the next time, stay safe, stay secure.